Did you realize that the first audiences watched a motion picture flicker on the screen in 1895? That's over 100 years ago. In that short time since 1895, movies have developed from a simple recording device. In the very beginning, it was like a travelogue, a scenic view that was being shown. Sometimes it was a not-so-scenic view, such as feeding the chickens. What they were doing was recording moving pictures. From these very simple beginnings, the movies developed into a complex art form and became a booming business. The first movie audiences were delighted to see that it was possible to record a moving scene on film. Today, we debate the desirability rather than the possibility of capturing an image. The important question for the first film audiences was, is the image discernible? Rather than, is the image meaningful? From the simplest beginnings of turning a camera on to record a scene, filmmakers have learned that their art depends on the way their cameras shape the scene that they are recording. Comparable to the novel, the completed narrative film is not just a story, but a story told in a certain way, and it is impossible to separate what is told and how it is told. Just as novelists discovered that narrative technique can be either subtly invisible, as in Hemingway, or intrusively self-conscious, as in Faulkner, so too the filmmaker can construct a lucid, apparently artless story, or a complex, almost chaotic maze for traveling to the story. The wonder is that while the evolution of narrative fiction can be traced back to Homer, the movies have evolved such complex techniques in just over a century. The current film generation may prefer seeing movies to reading novels, or making movies to writing poetry. But as a whole, the current film generation is surprisingly ignorant of the evolution of the art of film. In this class, you will see technically correct pictures on film, clearly focused, showing properly exposed images. You will realize the power of different pictorial compositions, the strategies of long shots and close-ups, the effects of different lenses and filters, and the power of editing in creating a film's meaning and tone. We will see the beauty of silent films with musical accompaniment, films that evolved during the first 35 years of film history, and then we will see the strength and beauty of color films with synchronized sound. In some way, film as an art is like fiction, drama, theater, dance, painting, photography, and music all rolled up in one. Like these art forms, it has a poetics all its own. When the early film turned from scenic views to fictional stories, directors assumed that the poetics of film were similar to those of the stage. Stage acting, stage movement, stage stories, and stage perspectives dominated early story film. The camera was assumed to be a passive spectator in a theater audience. And just as the spectator has only one seat, the camera had only one position, from which to shoot a scene. This is most clear in the short film A Trip to the Moon by filmmaker, theater artist, and magician Georges Méliès. Film is very different from the stage. In the stage, space is concrete. Scenery is fixed. It's behind the action. But space in film is completely elastic. Only the film is fixed, not the action on it. Directors discovered that the unit of a film is the shot, not the scene. Shots can be joined together in a number of combinations to produce whole scenes. And scenes can be varied and juxtaposed and paralleled in any number of ways. Unity of place, a basic and practical principle of the stage, does not apply to the movies. Instead, we have unity of action, an appropriate succession of images that produces the desired narrative continuity, the intended meaning, the appropriate emotional tension of the film as a whole. By the end of the silent era, this principle had been discovered and mastered. Over the next few weeks, you will see two very short, early silent films. One is called A Trip to the Moon, and the other one, A Great Train Robbery. Also, you'll be seeing the film classics by Charlie Chaplin, Gold Rush and Payday, and the great silent film, The General, by Buster Keaton. You've actually seen today some clips from those five films. To view these films, you might want to come into Long Beach City College Liberal Arts Library and view them on site. Or you may choose to call around to the local libraries and see if you can find these films available for you to check out. Or, of course, you can go to your local vendors of DVDs and videos and look under Silent Film Classics. The discussion forum question is completed online. It will relate to these films that you've seen, as well as information that you've read in the textbook, information that you've read online on the lectures, information on the study guides. The study guides will help you specifically with these five films. All of that information is located on the webpage. I look forward to reviewing your comments about the films that we've seen in class. If you're watching this supplemental portion online, you will find an exercise to do after the viewing. The exercise is done online. An immediate response showing your comprehension of what you have viewed will appear on the screen after you have submitted your exercise.